So today we will read chapter 3, noun clause and adjective clause. Student, I have already explained you what is mean by clause. Student, clause means a part of sentence which have a subject and predicates of its own. Okay? Student, if a part of the sentence make complete sense in itself, it is called main clause. Okay? And if a part of sentence does not make complete sense, okay, it is a dependent clause. Then it is called subordinate clause. Okay? Student, in this chapter we will talk about noun clause and adjective clause. Student, noun clause means a clause which does the function of a noun. Okay, which act as a noun. See how noun clause can be used as subject of a verb, and it can be used as an object of transitive verb. It can be used as complement of intransitive verb. It can be used object of the preposition, and it can be used as apposition also. Okay. First of all, as a subject of the verb, example, that he was innocent was proved by a lawyer. Okay, student, there are two clauses in this sentence. Is that was proved by a lawyer, it's a principal clause, and subordinate clause is that he was innocent. When we ask the question, what was proved by a lawyer, answer is that he was innocent. Okay, so it is the subject. So the noun clause can be used as a subject here. That he was innocent, it is a noun clause. It is used as a subject here. Okay. Now object of intransitive verb. If noun clause can be used as an object, like Seema is saying that she will meet me tomorrow. If we answer, if we put a question, what is Seema saying? We get the answer that she will meet me, that she will meet me tomorrow. So it is an object of the intransitive verb saying. So here noun clause is used as an object of intransitive verb. Okay. The complement of intransitive verb here. The soldier is what I want to become. Okay. Student, in this sentence the main clause is a soldier is, and the subordinate clause what I want to become. So when we put a question with the intransitive verb is with what, okay, answer we get it what I to become. Okay, what I want to become make the complete sense of the sentence. Okay, so therefore it is a complement of the verb is. It is a complement, therefore it is a noun clause. Now the object of a preposition. I was thinking of what needed to be done. In this sentence we ask a question, what was thinking of what, was thinking of what, answer we get it what needed to be done. Okay, it is a subordinate clause. It is the object of the preposition was, of, of. Okay, because it answered the question thinking of what, therefore it's a noun clause. Okay, so now comes apposition. Noun clause can also be used in apposition. If we leave out the noun clause when it is used in apposition, the sentence will still generate complete sense. Like the rumor that he was dead turned out to be false. The lie that you were absent one day will get you into trouble. The student, in sentence 1, the clause that he was responsible for the student accident gives more detail about the rumor. However, if we leave it out, the sentence read as the rumor turned out to be false, and it still makes some sense. Okay, what is apposition, student? It is a clause that provides more information about the noun clause or pronoun clause that is a part of main clause. Okay, student, so a noun clause used in apposition begin with subordinating conjunction that, and it can be replaced by any other subordinating clause.